California's marriage amendment, Prop 8, drew high emotions and lots of cash on both sides. Californians and out-of-staters raised a combined $74 million. That is more than twice the total spent in 24 other states on similar measures.
We've had a lot of support from people outside of the state, as has the other side, because everyone recognizes the huge cultural influence that California has on the whole country and our country throughout the world.
Prop 8 started in San Diego, where a group of pastors initiated a petition drive. At their victory party, they explained what helped Prop 8 succeed. Senator Obama, yes, the president-elect who opposed Prop 8, brought African Americans and Hispanics to the polls, and they voted for Prop 8. Also, John McCain's running mate, Sarah Palin, helped galvanize California's conservative voters. And there was another factor, a diverse mix of faith groups.
When biblical issues are at stake, we do have a new bridging across a lot of theological divides.
Garlow also credits a group of prayer warriors who fasted for 40 days before the election.
The first bump we got was a 10-point switch announced on October the 6th. In 11-day span, it made that kind of a change, and that was the first 12 days of our fast.
So what does California's marriage amendment vote mean? For starters, it puts the status of more than 10,000 same-sex marriages into question after the state Supreme Court legalized gay marriage earlier this year. That decision gave supporters of same-sex marriage a powerful weapon. They argued that Prop 8 was taking away rights. That despite a 2000 vote where Californians approved a law defining marriages only for a man and a woman. Also, combine Prop 8 with similar votes against same-sex marriage in Arizona and Florida on Tuesday, and social conservatives say it sends a strong signal about the will of the people.
That beams a powerful message to President-elect Obama and to the Congress, don't mess with marriage. There's a nation that's going to rise up. If California can go this way, then so can the rest of the nation.
Obama has promised to repeal the Federal Defense of Marriage Act. But with California, Arizona, and Florida now on the table, many analysts say it may be time to recalculate the political equation. Heather Sell, CBN News in San Diego.